tonight. My name is Ebby. I'm here at the bar. I got the G's and T's, and on stage I have George and Tyrone, and they're going to tell us what's going on in the Music Land.
The other G&T.
We're the other G&T. Welcome, everyone. To tonight's episode of In Music Land Tonight. We've got a massive, massive, massive show. We've got very lucky tonight.
Yeah, that's why we look like rednecks.
Why do we look like rednecks? No, we don't look like rednecks. We're going for the whole trucking country vibe. Talking about trucking country vibe, on tonight's show, we're very lucky. We have the almighty band, Truck. Oh, what'd you stop it for? I was enjoying that. Starting to dance on the inside.
And we're kicking off some country music with the rock man Kush Rider.
I want to know how many takes that took to stay on that ball.
I'd say one.
Just one?
Yeah.
Very short take. All right, Ibs, what do you got for us this week?
I have some funny things. Animal videos, of course.
Again.
Yes. And the band clip of the week this week has a sentimental little fun fact to me, actually. But it's a surprise, obviously. But
sentimental fun fact for you and for Tyrone.
And for me, too.
Yes, yeah. Ebby's band clips.
Oh, sorry, it's about all about Ebby.
You're the boss.
We're also going to be discussing how music affects your emotions.
Mm-hmm.
Not only in the bedroom, no.
In the car, in the shower.
Everything. So it's going to be a massive discussion about that. Now, for everyone at home, we are filming on Are You OK Day. So it is something that's very close to all of us. So make sure that if... Go and speak to someone. That's the whole purpose of Are You OK? Is to go out and actually talk to other people and find out if they're all right.
Even if you're all right and you know someone else, you still go and ask them.
Yes.
Still go and talk to them.
Yeah. Even if you think you're all right, you should just check with someone else. George.
What are you looking at me for? I'm always all right.
You guys look like you could be cousins and husbands.
Broke back Music Land TV.
We drive the same truck.
Hey?
We share the same cabin.
Yeah, why not?
Why not?
There's nothing wrong with that. What was that?
I don't know.
Huh? Thank God, I'm a country boy. All right, so we're going to organise the guys from Truck to jump up. They're going to take us out to the break very, very soon. But talking about, what are we talking about? Talking about Are You OK Day.
Oh, yeah.
Hey?
Yes.
What are you laughing about now?
I'm distracted with the clothes, I think.
With the what?
The clothes.
Leave your clothes alone.
Yeah.
Are you OK?
No, I'm not all right now. I'm getting picked on. You're still picking on me. Why are you looking at me like that for?
Sorry.
It's not very nice.
Are You OK Day is very important. And every day, I think so.
No, it is. It is.
The awareness has been brought, but just keep it up.
What?
Ask Are You OK every day.
Yes, you should. You should ring up your mates and ask them if they're all right.
Yeah.
Especially with musicians. You've got places like Lifeline, Beyond Blue, for musos and roadies and all of that. You've got Support Act. There's a hell of a lot of different sort of services and everything that are available to everyone. But the main thing is just go through your whole phone, scroll down through thing, just pick a number one day and just ring someone. Mm. And just say, hello, how are you?
Every day.
Every day.
Not just today.
But make sure that you listen to them. Even if what they're talking about might not interest you or whatever the case is, just listen to them.
Mm. Yeah, it makes a difference, yeah.
It does make a difference.
You don't know where people are in life, so just... I saw a note there that you cry when Jesse's girl comes on.
What was that? No, what? I haven't gotten up to that point yet.
I'm asking now.
What?
Why do you always cry when Jesse's girl is on?
We can't get into that conversation at the moment. It's just a freaking terrible, terrible, terrible song. It should be banned. That's what it is.
Okay.
What?
We've all got sentimental fun facts tonight.
No, there's a whole set list of songs that cover bands should just not play.
And we've got them all here.
Hold on, let me get a longer list. Well, Gary, one of our awesome sound techs and one of the guys that runs behind the scenes, if you ever see him, his favourite song is Hallelujah. So if anyone ever sees Gary in the street or anything, just go up, give him a hug and start singing Hallelujah. That'll help Gary every single time.
And then Jesse's Girl.
And Jesse's Girl.
And then wish him a happy birthday. Yeah.
And then, what's the other one? April Sun in Cuba?
Oh, that's our set.
Is that your set? Sorry, that's a guy from Top Set. That's what they...
Great segue.
Exactly. Talking about truck, after the break, we're going to be chatting with one of the hardest working rock country men, Kush Ryder. Ebby's going to board us some clips, more bloody clips about animals playing music, again.
There's
but they're
lot.
Always fun.
And some other random things. Yeah,
the internet
as well.
Is never ending.
And George and Tyrone will discuss why George always cries while Jesse Girls plays. No, it's how music affects your emotions. But guys, please put your hands together for Truck with their song, Make Hay.
Thank you, Music Land.
Jesse's Girl, you ready?
Fucking up the window, trying to get a glimpse of
Yeah, that way, that way. Thanks, guys. Whoop. Truck. All right. You're not George?
No, I'm not.
No.
No, I'm not.
Where is it? Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
I just wanted to be like Bachelor Wanted a Husband. What's it called? Bachelor Wanted a Husband. Farmer wants a something or other. That's terrible. I borrowed your hat.
You've gone from my truck brother to like my hillbilly incest sister.
Yeah, I know. Hold on, we've got to fix the lights. Ready? One, two, three, front lights. Down the bottom, on the left-hand side. Nearly. It's all right, we'll fix it up in a second. There we go.
There we go. Chris Ryder.
Chris Ryder,
how are you going?
Get rid of this hat. It's just annoying me and it's creeping everyone out at home. Sorry.
All right, so.
I see you.
Where are your humble beginnings?
Oh, humble beginnings.
Yeah, where did you start?
Obviously at school, yeah, school. I was always the kid that was...
You get in trouble?
Yeah, that was that. But I was always, you know, from the classroom at lunch, we had the music department and it had a drum, a bass guitar, a piano and a guitar. And so whenever you finish school or the class go down to lunch, race down to the down the music department and whatever instrument you got. There we go. Is that better? Everyone get in. And so, yeah, whatever instrument you got first up was the instrument you played for lunchtime. So I was always chasing the guitar and that's how I started. So my first band was a bunch of anybody's from wherever in the school. That was it. That's where I started.
All right. Now, you went and lived in America for a while.
Yeah.
Did that influence any of your current music?
Yeah, probably in not so much in influenced by other artists, but certainly playing, learning to play with other musicians and forming bands that did or didn't work. So yeah, there was definitely an influence in. I lived in New York and I was based in Florida for a while as well.
That's so country.
Yeah, that's right. Never been to Nashville, haven't been to Texas yet, but that's on the cards. But yeah, no, definitely the international travel was there. I spent about 11 years in Argentina as well. So, but there was no influence there. None of my music is in Spanish nor do I play flamenco.
You should. Flamenco, Spanish, country.
Country, just a real mix there. So yeah, you know, but influences come from, they can come from anyone and everyone really. Any musician, it's always there. It's always feeding, yeah.
So what made you get into country music?
I was always into it. I was always, I was into country before I knew that I was into country music. Like, I was listening to Waylon Jennings as a young fella. I knew of Willie, Kenny, you know, and even back home, you know, Cold Chisel and a lot of those big Australian rock bands, a lot of their influences can actually be found in good old classic country music. That's sort of where it came from. And then country sort of evolved into rock. And now we've got rock, and rock just keeps evolving now till it's almost not even rock anymore. But and then I guess there's a newer part though. Like the last 5-6 years, I've been much more active into country and listening into strictly country music artists and things like that. So it's not all I listen to. I mean, I still listen to Spanish music. I still listen to jazz, tango, all sorts of types of music, even smooth jazz. It's really good.
Smooth jazz.
Yeah, it's really like good when you want to clean the house. Change your palette of music and put on some smooth jazz.
Actually, we're going to have a discussion about that. I hold that thought, definitely.
So, that, obviously, the scene, the country scene between here and America, for example, is totally different.
Yeah.
Where did you find that you picked up the most love for your music?
Definitely out of the American scene, for sure. The Australian country music scene has sort of got two sides. There's the American influence. Country rock stuff where there's American accents in the songs by Australians, and then there's the whole the sheep shearing, the sunburnt country, you know, the sunburnt plains kind of country music of Australia, and it's, you know, with a thick Australian accent. I'm of the former, not of the latter. So you know, I love singing about, you know, Saturday nights and bars and a bottle of Jack Daniels, and that's really literally most of the theme to many of my songs. But hey, you know, I don't shear sheep, but I'll drink Jack Daniels. So,
do you drive a truck?
I drive a ute and it's beat up. You know, it'll make it home just. but so that'll do. But no, I don't drive a Chevy. I don't pretend to be American. Either. I mean, it's just the influence and how my music comes through with songwriting and things like that. So it's just sort of what comes naturally, I guess.
And you're a multi-instrumentalist.
I guess. Is that more than one instrument? Yeah. I guess I play keyboards. I play piano as well. Growing up, I played clarinet and saxophone. I was dreadful at it. I didn't retain anything, but that was certainly my musical, beginning. So actually right now I'm writing a lot more songs on piano at home because I found one on the street. So I brought it home, put it in the back of my ute.
They're the best ones, the free ones.
Yeah.
I love anything free.
A few busted keys and it doesn't quite work, but it's good enough to write songs on it. So,
Trash and treasure.
Yeah, that's what works. I mean, I'd be happy finding a guitar on the street as well, but this was... and then, of course, singing. So, like singing. But I don't really know sort of what I prefer. I just like it all. Whatever. Anything that makes noise, really.
Now, you're going to be performing the song Ride Me?
Yes. Yeah.
Awesome. So what we're going to do, we're going to get you to set up and do that.
Cool.
We're going to cross over to Ebby. And Ebby is going to tell us, or Ebby's going to show us what she's found this week for her internet finds. Ebby.
Hello. Yes, indeed I am. And I haven't been at school this week, so I've spent a lot of time on the internet trolling through the depths to find the funnies. This first one, I don't even remember what it is, to be honest. It's called Bird Harp. That one was just personal.
That must have been very freaking personal.
Next up, we have a very talented little feathery friend, Boogie Bird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Next, I'm going to give a lot of credit to the interpreters that do this, but this one is what it's like at a Pearl Jam concert. Here we go. On a year, on a wizard, on a way, yeah. And a cold, and a thin, and a wool, and a thin, and a cold out.
That's about right.
I thought you'd like that one.
You got to give them props.
Next up, this is what it's like when music really speaks to you. Shania.
Shania! I just got a new car.
Okay, so you got a car.
What do you think?
That don't impress me much.
How rude!
Whatever.
This next one is dedicated to my dad. It's lucky that he had kids, so then his jokes make sense, otherwise he'd just be weird. This one's titled Dad Joke.
Can't get too far without these!
That just went to a whole new level.
That was different.
So also, shout out to George.
Hi, kids.
Next up, this one's called Acoustic Man.
Hey, this is my impression of an acoustic guitar.
That's good. Very clever.
Very clever.
Some people are born with talent. Everyone's born with talent, actually. Some people are just born with a little bit extra. This one's called Nose Singer.
I don't want to set the world on fire.
I was killing myself in the dish today watching that. That actually made me laugh.
Next up, this is called Holy Cow.
Holy cow!
Sure. short but sweet. I like that. This one is my personal favorite, Jazz Man. That one's dedicated to Tyrone.
Oh, what? Oh, why?
Previous episode discussion. All right. Anyway,
next you dance better than that.
We're going to listen to Kush Rider with his song Ride Me.
Put your hands together, everyone. Kush Rider. Hey, what's that? Yeehaw. That's all I have to say.
That's actually really good acoustically.
It is. Yeah. Knew a guy who knew a guy who played drums with him. But not allowed to say that, are we?
No.
No.
This week's discussion, this week's chat, we're going to be chatting about how your mood and emotions are affected by music. Mm-hmm. Now, one of the biggest things is, and I like to talk about, is driving songs. What's your favourite driving song?
I had a song by Disturbed called Stricken that I used to put on when I was driving.
You'd be a mental driver.
I was a maniac. I loved it.
Yeah?
Yep.
I listen to smooth jazz, like Nick was saying before, when I drive to some cool Karma Collective. No.
What song?
Hey?
What song?
You don't like the songs that I listen to. I'm not even going to...
It's rap, wasn't it?
It is. Yeah. Yeah. It is. It's my hip-hop and rap. What do you listen to, Nick? Come over here. Grab this mic.
He did say he clings to smooth jazz. I don't know why I put that there.
That's actually a good point, doing different things to different music.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So, I mean, I don't clean the house as often as I should, but when I do it to smooth jazz. It's great. It just changes your whole thing because I'm always listening to country music or whatever it is, you know, because I love it. And of course, I'm always listening for listening out for new influences and things, write a new song or whatever, or somewhere, or some new artist. But smooth jazz is just instrumental, it's great.
Funnily enough, I actually listen to Kerry Underwood when we clean the house.
Right.
Because that's what I'm told that I have to listen to when I clean the house. And got no choice.
Yeah. But yeah, driving, you got to have driving music. Tom Petty's always good. You know, Tom Petty's running down a dream.
What about to unwind? What do you do to unwind?
I listen to crooner music. Buble's.
You go through phases, don't you? Yes. Go through, you know, you might go through years of listening to crooner music and cocktail music and things like that. And then all of a sudden you're into something completely different.
But then I travel on a plane, I listen to Pink Floyd's Pulse album from start to halfway through. Usually I've fallen asleep and then I'll wake up, have something to eat and then keep listening to the other half and fall asleep again. Right. It's just the best.
Yeah, definitely.
Music for all occasions. Music is always on at my house, always on.
But then you listen to some music and you'd be sitting there driving down the road with tears streaming out of your eyes because it hit you emotionally.
Jesse's Girl?
No, not Jesse's Girl. Usually gets turned on the radio and trying to push the button fast enough to turn it over. Yeah. No, but it's true. You listen to some music, you're driving down the road and the guy's looking at next to you going, look at this miserable bastard, got tears streaming down your face.
Yeah, I've never had that.
Hey?
I've never had that.
Men are allowed to cry.
Yes, they are.
I mean, that's right, and there are whole genres of music which give you emotion, like, you know, tango, or like if you want to go down that way, or just a good piano ballad, you know, anything. You might not even be listening to the lyrics, just the emotion in the song. You know, a great, beautiful piano ballad can be something that just sets you off.
Does listening to it and playing it give you different emotions?
Yeah, there are some songs that can be emotive, yeah, definitely. Whether they're ones I've written or covers, yeah, but mainly like in the band, like we write happy songs, up songs. I want an up, a high energy set. I don't want to bring people down at a live gig. That's not what they're for. I might record a sad song, but certainly to play live, you know, you don't want to have people slashing their wrists, you know, sort of thing, and feeling
it's a bit morbid,
feeling upset, or you know, or drowning in a bottle, I should say, or whatever.
What do you like playing? Like, if you're in a shit mood, what music do you like?
You know what? I used to go outside and lock myself in the back room and play drums for hours.
How'd you go outside and lock yourself in the back room at the same time?
Because I had the key in
the outhouse.
Oh, yeah.
I used to just sit there and play drums for as long as I could. And that would actually calm me down. And believe it or not, if I had like headaches and things like that, it would soothe it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
See, I'm the same. I'll come here on a Sunday night, and for me, this is my release. Can be listening, and I couldn't care less what we played, except for Jesse's Girl, April Sun in Cuba, and a couple of other songs. But anything else, it's just like an absolute release to be able to go through the whole emotional spectrum and be able to just smash it out.
Mm. Yeah.
Sorry, we play drums.
Yeah, like different language.
Sing like some people.
Yeah, I don't do the rhythm thing very well.
Yep. Something can't play. All right. On that note, do you want to add anything else to this?
No, I think it's all written down and
it's all been covered.
It's all been covered.
Yeah. What about yourself? Yeah, no, I'm good. Add anything does anyone else know? All right, so...
Actually, I wouldn't mind asking the guys some track that same question later on.
Actually, we will. Yeah. I want to ask Evie, what do you like listening to?
What, in general or...?
No, if you're in an emotional mood, what sort of music do you like listening to?
What makes you feel good?
Well, I grew up emo, so I listen to the most depressing shit you could think of. Makes me feel good. But also, like, all blues. I also like Billie Holiday's sad music when I'm sad, but... Yeah, I don't know.
What about to make you happy?
Emo, depressing.
Yeah, same.
Side trance. Yeah, also, that's my driving music, but it kind of depends on the speed limit.
Now we know. All right, we're going to go over to a break. We're going to get you to set up again.
Cool.
Because Chris is going to be performing another song in a second. So after the break, we have a band smashing it in the live scene at the moment called Truck. Really looking forward to that.
Yeah.
And Ebby is going to show us a clip of a band that is dear to her heart.
Clip of the week. Yeah.
Clip of the week.
Yep.
Dear to her heart and dear to Tyrone's heart.
How is it dear to your heart?
No, she's going to tell us after.
Oh.
What a break.
Now?
That is. Do you want to tell us? You tell us now, and Nick's going to go and sit down.
Okay, cool. Well, this, as a lover of live music, this band, Closure in Moscow, were my very first band that I saw live. as a little 14-year-old at an all-ages gig, and I travelled 2.5 hours to Canberra, and it changed my life, essentially. That's my sentimental fun fact. Tyrone has one too, apparently, but...
I just went to school with a guitarist. That's
big
it.
Big deal.
Big deal. They were like my first gig that I went to at
and we were friends and we played music together.
Eh? You what?
We were friends and we played music together.
Yeah. At school.
Yeah.
In school.
Yeah.
At school?
In school.
In school. All right.
All right.
That's it. We're done. That's it. I've lost it now completely, but that's all good.
Kush Ryder with You're My Country Song. Kush Ryder, You're My Country Song. How'd that make you feel?
Yeah, good, yeah.
Mate, I still feel good.
How'd that
too.
Make everyone feel?
Yeah.
Good? Good.
Good, happy song, man.
All right, we're very lucky to have two awesome musos from the band that we've got performing tonight. Truck, we've got Andy and...
Kevin. Hello.
Kev.
Hello.
Kevin.
That's hey, great. How are you?
Hey, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
Right, good, thanks.
Hey, this is awesome.
It's Tuesday, try the veal.
Now I've got one.
Right, no, we're all right.
Oh, you're mic'd up.
No, we're mic'd up. Sure. You guys get to have that thing.
Awesome.
First things first, where'd the name come from?
Motorcycle sounded shit.
What about bicycle?
Bicycle?
Yeah.
Melbourne Star.
Melbourne's doing hard rock quickly. Truck sounded good.
Pretty much.
Yeah,
pretty much
it.
It's catchy.
I think so.
That was the quickest question. That's the only question Gary wanted us to ask. Where did the name truck come from?
Where'd you get the shirts?
Back of your truck.
Back of your truck. They fell out the back of the truck.
Oh, speaking of shirts.
Yeah, speaking about shirts and falling out the back of the truck, we've got Truck's album here, Light Hill.
No, that's the EP.
That's the EP, yeah. Sorry. EP. What's the difference between an album, an EP, and an LP? I don't know.
The difference between an EP and an LP?
Extended play, long play.
So we added some more tracks to make it the album.
That's for those people playing at home.
Yeah, because it was. It could be two more better than this.
Yes. Now, where does the whole sound of Truck come from? Where's your inspiration? Where does the music and the creativity come from?
I think, for me, the stars aligned when we were demoing some stuff in a studio. Kevin and I have known each other for a long, long time, and Mark and I have been jamming together, keyboard player, for a long, long time as well. And when we thought we were going to put a new band together because this was goddamn fun, we ended up in a studio doing some recording. And studios are a bit like... that's where you're going to find the cracks in whatever you're doing. And there were some cracks in what we were doing. And it was obvious that the lineup wasn't quite right yet. And at that point, Kev goes, well, let's look up a guitarist that I'm mates with on Facebook. Some bloke called Dave Leslie from the Baby Animals. And I said, well, why not?
Yep.
Let's go for him.
Yeah, that's right.
And he just happened to... Small World.
No, Alex.
No, but Ricky Ray, the guy we were recording the tracks with, just happened to be their sound guy. And I can't remember the question, but I'll tell you this story anyway. So suddenly, you know, we're calling up Dave going, would you like to come and join? And in the meantime, Ricky Ray had played some of our demos
to Dave. Yeah.
And Dave had gone...
And luckily he loved it.
So he says. No, so and suddenly, and when he came along, and then Truck was born. And it's been fun ever since. Where does the sound come from? I think when you just love music, and we're all of the vintage of, I think we're all born in the 60s, are we not?
Yep.
So we all grew up with 70s records, you know, and I think... I know, Mark, we talk about John Lord on the keyboards a lot, you know, the Deep Purple sound. And I think for us as a band, suddenly, or for me, having been with bands before with dueling guitars, it was great to be in a band with keys and guitar. And so suddenly the lineup makes the sound, what you love musically makes the sound. But before you know it, you are what you are. And if the lineup's great and you're having fun, it just is a thing. I talk for hours now.
This is gross. I'll stay here. This has like been the easiest interview ever. I haven't had to think yet.
You know, I watched that thing the other night, the Wembley Stadium thing or whatever it was with it, and you got all these...
5-8?
Yeah, no. Hawkins.
Yes.
And you see these guys doing other people's songs, and it's never the same. When the band... not necessarily the most... You don't have to be the most talented people, but the chemistry between the players, whatever it is in that particular lineup, makes that sound. And I think when we did Truck, when that lineup came together, everyone just went, there's something good there.
Yeah.
So I think in answer to your question, where's the sound come from? It is what it is.
Now, I heard a little bit of a rumour before that... So you guys obviously have been lucky enough to support Baby Animals.
Now we know someone.
Yeah, I know. Now that you know someone. But does Dave get the whole thing of that when he actually does sound check with you guys? Does the sound guy just say to him, right, you're done, that's enough? Bit of second degree service there?
Do we, as the support act, get slightly better treatment than a normal support act because we've got the headline act on guitar? Is that your question?
No, I was also talking about Dave.
it's good. It's good we've been touring. We toured with them.
Yeah,
a dozen shows or something.
Yeah. We've done about a dozen, and we all over the place, and it's been good. It's been really good.
Yeah. We get well looked after.
We do.
You can tell who the singer is holding the mic.
Yeah. Yeah.
Talking about that, Kev, we're actually going to get you guys to perform now.
Awesome.
Yeah, that was a good chat with you, Kev.
That was easy.
But we are. We're going to get you guys to perform now. You're going to be doing Unconventionally Rising. But before we do that, we're going to cross over to Ebby. Oh, Ebby. God, I can't even talk now. We're going to cross over to Ebby for her band clip of the week.
Yay! Thanks, George.
So we're setting up.
This song is by a...
Where up?
It says it is. Anyway, this song is called A Happy Days by A Closure in Moscow.
Check it out. I won't let anyone ever see until you bring me down. Pretty little thing came up behind me, twisted, twirled, she damn near blind me. Then she smiled as she took my crown. I chased that pretty little thing all the way up the mountain just to see what I could see, what I could see. Yeah, I saw her standing by the flagpole. Guess what she said to me? You're chasing happy days. Tell me, are you close enough? The view up here, should have seen it from the start. You're chasing every day. Tell me, are you closer now? Praising yesterday, dreaming of them better times. Dancing around the sun, hard to believe I was swimming in my mind, lost in the sea. Quick fix schemes had a hold on me. Now I just smile because everything always was just the way that it should have been. All them happy days are here. Yeah, feeling good, feeling fine. Excuse me while it blows my mind.
Thank you.
song.
How about that?
That's a wonderful choice.
Love that.
Thank you. You never say that. How about that jacket, hey, though? I feel like I need one of those. Next up, we have Truck with the song Unconventional Rising.
Yeah.
exponentially rising.
Nice.
Get absolutely trapped, am I right?
How did it go before?
That's old news now.
Oh, sorry.
What have you got for us next week, George?
All right, on next week's show, we have a band called What We Became. So stranded.
And next week's acoustic artist is Rhys Tolhurst.
Shame as I walk out the door and I'm broken. Shame as I walk out the door and I'm broken.
Pretty nice.
That's very nice. I'm actually looking forward to Rhys. I've seen Rhys running around a fair bit, so that's going to be pretty cool. We'll also be discussing Ebby's internet finds of the week.
Yes.
What are they?
I don't know yet, and it's not next week. They're all fresh, hot and fresh out the kitchen, George.
That was a good chat. Thanks for that. That was a good discussion. All right, guys, we're going to be saying our final goodbyes and our final thank yous now. Thank you to the amazing truck. Kush Rider. Thank you to Ebby. Thank you to the Musicland production crew, which include Gary, John, Red, Belinda, Mick, and the amazing Musicland bar staff, which this week we had Jeremy.
Not on camera, but hi.
Sponsors, we've got Creative Vic, Musicland, Mark Foods, Pubble, Three Cuts Gin, Chaos Drums, Rudiment Hardware, and Coca-Cola. And to finish the night off with their song, Lucky, we get to hear Truck once more to take us out to the credit. Please, everyone, put your hands together for Truck again. Yeah.